Rat lungworm disease has reached Hawaii, and while we have told you a lot about exactly what the disease is, do you know how to protect yourself? Dr. John McHugh, Administrator of Plant Industry Division of the Hawaii Department of Agriculture, is here on what can be done to protect ourselves. Good morning.
Good morning, Kelly.
Well, thank you so much for joining us.
You're welcome.
This is, you know, a big issue that a lot of people are concerned about, and I'm kind of curious as to where it starts, because of course, you know, we're talking about in the gardens. What can home gardeners as well as farmers do to prevent this? Because that's kind of where it starts, right?
Sure. I mean, I'm not quite sure where the notion came from that rat lung worm disease is associated with produce that farmers grow here in Hawaii. But the number one thing that farmers, gardeners can do to avoid this disease is to control rats, because
okay.
rats are the carriers for the disease.
Mm-hmm.
And then beyond that, if they should do something to control slugs and snails, because the rat lungworm disease parasite then it comes out in the rat poop, and then the slugs and the snails will eat it, and then we can get contamination and get sick if we eat a part of a slug or a part of a snail. I mean, it's hard to imagine that we would eat something that is so obvious, and really there's only three main types of slugs and snails that are, you know, implicated with this disease, and that would be African snails. Everybody knows what the giant African snail looks like.
Yeah.
Then there's what's called the Cuban slug, which is a very common slug that people will find in and around their gardens. And then a more recent introduction is called the semi-slug. And the semi-slug is called semi-slug because it has the appearance of a small shell on its back. It's not fully developed into a shell, so it doesn't really fit the definition of a snail.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah, so that particular slug has been implicated in a lot of the transmissions of the rat lungworm disease.
Mm.
And it's a relatively new invasive pest species that got here within the last 20 years, whereas African snail and the Cuban slug have been here in Hawaii for decades. And as it turns out, this semi-slug is very efficient at transmitting this disease.
Okay.
And so it can be anywhere from a very tiny slug, and it can get up to an inch or so. And so that's why it's important to wash the produce, is to make sure you can get any sign of any critters that might happen to be on your produce off of it.
And is that something that, well, for the main way of prevention at home, once you're buying produce, is that the main way then to kind of prevent it, the washing of the vegetables and everything?
Yeah, that's correct, because, I mean, we have a certain assumption that the vegetables or produce has been washed and cleaned before we've gotten it, but it's also been handled by others. And, you know, we have the supermarkets, and we like to have the choice of being able to select amongst the different products in the supermarket shelf, but, you know, people just paw through that, literally. And so it's always a good idea to wash produce when you take it home.
Right. And when you are, what are you looking for visually? What would someone kind of be on the eye out for?
Well, there's the slugs and the snails would be pretty obvious.
Right.
They look like especially the slug or the semi-slug, it looks like a small streak almost that's a quarter inch to an inch long, grayish in color. No real legs or anything on it because it kind of squirms around on its belly. And that would be the main thing to look for. You'd be looking for any types of animals like that that would be found on your produce.
Okay, wonderful. And great advice. And speaking of advice, you guys have informational meetings coming up. One's tonight. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Yeah, we had actually a couple of weeks ago, we had one at this location that is going to be at tonight at the Hawaii Agricultural Research Center in Kunia, which is right across from Village Park. That's from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. And then tomorrow we're going to do a repeat performance at the Kahuku High School on the North Shore, and that will also be at 6 p.m. to 8 p.m.
Okay, and the information is on your screen, so make sure you head on out to get more information on, again, how, just more about the disease and how you can be protecting yourself and your family. Doctor, thank you so much for joining us.
You're
really
welcome.
Appreciate all the
welcome.
Tips. Thank you.
Kelly.
All right.